Depression, an emotional state of mind characterized by feelings of low self-worth or guilt and a reduced ability to enjoy life. The various causes of clinical depression include genetic vulnerability, severe life stressors, substances like drugs or any sort of medications taken, traumatic events, and medical conditions. These can profoundly affect the way one's brain acts and regulates moods. The great Australian psychologist Dorothy Rowe once said, "Depression is a prison where you are both the suffering prisoner and the cruel jailer." Previously known as melancholia, depression is an illness that has existed for as long as we have. Many greats have contributed to what we know about it today, including Hippocrates of ancient Greece and Emil Kraepelin, the German psychiatrist. Today, depression affects countless people. A sort of chain reaction, you could say. It alters your behavior and the way you think, often affecting those close to you. A global estimated 300 million people of all ages suffer from depression. A colossal number, close to 4% of the current human population. This video will briefly explain the well of depression and the ways in which this illness can be treated. You may want to look out for the following symptoms of depression. Things like loss of interest in otherwise loved activities, hopeless outlook, increased fatigue and sleeping problems, anxiety, changes in appetite and weight, and uncontrollable emotions are determined signs and symptoms of depression. Numerous medical conditions may mimic depression, including vitamin deficiencies, anemia, low blood sugar, hypothyroidism, calcium abnormalities, and kidney or liver problems. These are especially true in older adults. If you experience any 5 of the above symptoms for at least 2 weeks, consult a doctor immediately. If the doctor says you qualify for a clinical diagnosis of depression, you will likely be directed to a mental health professional, such as a psychiatrist. A psychiatrist may further assess your mood and determine whether or not medication is required. Depression symptoms can range from moods such as anxiety, general discontent, guilt, hopelessness, loss of interest or mood swings, suicidal thoughts, sleeping time disturbances such as early awakening, excess sleepiness, insomnia, or restless sleep. The enormous consequences of untreated major depression include the likes of poor life choices, possible drug or alcohol addiction, problems with work or school, and not being able to love your family and friends. With that being said, let's move on to how to deal with depression. There are several different ways you can deal with depression and treat it. When someone gets cured of an illness, it means it is gone forever. Some illnesses cannot be cured, like diabetes. Once a person gets diabetes, sadly, they will have it for the rest of their life. However, even a lifelong illness like diabetes can be treated. People who take their medications regularly and make specific lifestyle changes can live long and healthy lives. These medications and lifestyle changes are treatments for diabetes. Depression is the same way. There is no exact cure for depression, but there are lots of effective treatments. People can recover from depression and enjoy living healthy lives. Many habits can influence your mental health, ensuring you get regular sleep, consume a balanced diet, and exercise regularly can help a lot. Some people benefit from reducing or eliminating the use of caffeine, alcohol, or drugs. Therapy can be an excellent way to modify behaviors, gain confidence, learn new skills, and simply talk with someone openly and honestly. There are countless different types of therapy. Most therapists use various techniques depending on the necessities of the person they're working with. The most common type of therapy for depression is cognitive behavioral therapy, or CBT for short. In CBT, a therapist helps you examine your thoughts and beliefs and how these influence your behavior. It's important to find support from others. This can come through family, friends, professionals, or support groups. Support groups are made up of individuals with similar experiences who meet regularly to discuss their lives. Talking to people who are in the same boat as you can make you feel less alone and more connected. It also creates a space where people can share what has worked for them and talk through their struggles with people who understand. Another option is to take medications. Medications that aim to treat depression are called antidepressants. They can be assorted into many different types. Examples include bupropion and nortriptyline. Medications affect everyone differently, so not every medication will work adequately for you, and many of them may have side effects. You'll need to sit with your doctor to find a medication that works best for you. It's also common to take multiple medications to target specific symptoms or to counteract side effects. When medication treatments fail to relieve, people can explore the use of device-based treatments for depression. These treatments include electroconvulsive therapy, ECT, vagus nerve stimulation, VNS, transcranial magnetic stimulation, TMS, or cranial electrotherapy stimulation, CES. Some of these procedures are done in a hospital under the care of a doctor, whilst others, like CES, are used at home and are small devices. Treating depression is extremely essential for patients suffering from it. Depression is a medical condition, just like asthma or diabetes. You mustn't be ashamed in the slightest for having depression. Nor should you hesitate in asking for help to deal with it. Do not assume it is going to disappear at will. That is the equivalent of directing your broken hand to fix itself. Remember, depression is neither a weakness nor a personality trait. People suffering from depression take, on average, 10 years to ask for help. A sad figure, as it has led to all sorts of issues. If you suffer from depression, feel no embarrassment in consulting doctors, talking freely to therapists, or anybody for that matter, to obtain relief. Research shows that even conversations with loved ones or support groups about thoughts of suicide can reduce suicide risk. Furthermore, regardless of whether you have or haven't undergone depression in the past, you can help the ones currently undergoing depression around you. Having simple conversations about the other person's thoughts and what they're going through in a good, helpful fashion and listening to them intently can have a tremendously positive effect. However, please refrain from giving examples of any short, sad moments that you might have felt. Everyone feels depressed or sad every now and then. It's a common feeling that is temporary and happens due to arguments, failed tests, or even when it rains. These arguments don't connect well with those diagnosed with depression because it is like comparing a minor muscle twist to a ligament tear. Two vastly divergent experiences that, when compared, would lead to the person feeling guiltier in suffering from depression due to the false comparison. Depression is different from feelings of sadness. It's infinitely more painful and doesn't go away at all easily. The best thing you can do to help is to listen to the person and refrain from adding negative remarks to their feelings. Never pressurize them into believing depression does not exist. Never tell a patient to get it together, because that would be the equivalent of telling an asthma patient to just breathe. Doing this could easily lead to them falling deeper into the well of depression. Instead, you can suggest the treatments they can take to obtain relief. Remember, suicide is never an option, regardless of it being passive or active suicidality. If you or anyone else you know have recurring suicidal thoughts, have earnest conversations to reduce suicide risk, or contact a helpline number where professionals are ready to meet needs and offer practical solutions. Thank you for watching this video. If you feel it's worth sharing, please do so with the ones you know to spread this vital information. Thank you once again. Have a great day.